grow.
Love is little, love is low, love will make our spirit grow. Grow in peace, grow in light, love will do the thing that's right. Grow in peace, grow in light, love will do the thing that's right.
The peak of Shaker furniture making was the pre-Civil War era, roughly at the same time of the peak of membership in Shaker Society. At this time, there were approximately 6,000 Shakers. The first furniture was donated by original members. However, the amount of furniture donated proved to be insufficient due to the growing number of Shakers. There was a demand for more furniture to fill the meeting rooms and dwellings. The Shakers were faced with the predicament of whether to buy furniture from outside their communities versus making their own furniture. Many of the Shakers had a background of mechanical trades from their time before joining the Shaker Society, which led the Shakers to the decision to start their own furniture making.
The folks who came here as Shakers were Kentuckians first, and if they, you know, if a fellow was a cabinet maker, he had been making presses, for instance, and knew what made it pretty, and he pared away some of the decorative elements, but he still kept that same style.
The Shakers did not want to use European styles with large beds and their extravagant designs. They decided to stay away from the worldly designs and surface decorations. Although the style at the time was to use a light stain and heavy varnishes, the Shakers chose not to do this on their furniture. The Shakers wanted to show the beauty of the natural wood as God had created it in its perfection.
While the Shakers did not want their furniture to take on a European style, they also chose not to use the style of furniture of the farms at that time because of the bulkiness and low functionality it provided. Instead, the Shakers wanted their furniture to be used for multi-purposes. For example, chairs were used not only for sitting, but also with special knobs so that they may be used to hang coats. Many pieces had drawers so that they could also be used for storage, some even with drawers on both sides. The furniture was also made so that it could be easily moved. The beds had rollers on the bottom so that the room could be rearranged at any time with great ease. The chairs were small so they could be slid underneath other pieces of furniture or hung on the pegs on the walls. The Shakers did not believe in wasting space with closets. Instead, they had pegs on the walls so that almost anything could be hung around the room. The light scones even had holes so that the lights could be raised when mopping or lowered when doing something while sitting, such as sewing.
Down in the lowly vale, living waters never fail, moved by the pleasant gale, gentle breezes blowing, where all earthly sorrows cease and eternal joys increase. Oh, the land of peace, there I will be going.
Shaker furniture was built from many different kinds of wood. The most common types included old pine, rock maple, maple, fruit wood such as apple, pear, and cherry, walnut, hickory, and ash. Maple wood was used for knobs and pegs, while rock maple was used for chairs and other furniture, which was functional and used often. Hickory and ash were used for curved furniture, like rocking chairs. Old pine and walnut were abundant and therefore used for making many types of furniture. Copper was not seen as a useful metal because the Shakers saw no monetary value in it, and therefore nails were made from copper because it was a decent material with no other uses for them. The Shakers also used wood pegs to hold things together. Overall, Shakers had two types of furniture. The first is called built-in, which consists of pegs, cupboards, and anything else which was built into the walls. The second is mobile, which includes chairs, tables, dressers, and all other movable types of furniture.
There are antecedents for Shaker furniture in the Sheraton and Heppelwhite and Queen Anne styles. They just got away from a lot of the decorative elements. A chair is beautiful because it functions well. And so you pare away all the unnecessary decorative items and get back to the simplicity.
The Shakers built their furniture in the same way as their architecture, with symmetry in all things. They did not want to take away from the natural beauty of the materials, because that was considered taking away from God. This could even be seen as adultery in the Shaker society, because it was viewed as cheating on God. All the Shaker furniture was built for God as a form of worship. They exemplified God's work in nature as the best and most perfect. They did not believe in trying to make something elaborate, because it would not be as good in quality or appreciated, as God's work was always better. However, the Shakers did not recognize talents within their community, and those who excelled in their trade were put to work in at least one of their specialties. For the most part, Shakers did not sign their furniture they made, simply because it was made with the idea that it was built to exemplify God, not to show off individual work. Another common belief was that Shaker furniture was made so that angels could sit on it. While physical comfort was not the goal of Shaker furniture, it was built to bring comfort to the soul, which was the ultimate comfort.
The Shakers believed that their work was an act of worship. They did their work the best way they knew how, because it gave glory to God. And part of this goes back to one of their fundamental religious beliefs. They believe they're living in the millennium, the thousand-year reign of Christ on earth. And so if you believe you're living in the thousand-year reign of Christ, if you have 1,000 years to get it right. And so it doesn't matter whether it's not production line mentality. You're not trying to pump out as many chairs as you can. You're going to make that chair the best way you know how.
Different Shaker regions came up with different ideas and new designs and shared them with one another. Their ideas were adapted from region to region based on the resources of individual communities and their needs. All the Shaker communities were not exactly the same, which created differences in their needs. Things such as climate varied, and although the furniture would look very similar, the design may vary for functional purposes.
They believed that the beauty of any object was in its utility, in how it functioned. The press here is a good example. You'll notice there's a floating panel here set in a case that enables the wood to expand and contract along with the changing heat and humidity. A similar piece over here from New England is a solid board because they don't have the heat and the humidity.
The Shakers have had an immense impact on modern design, and this can be seen through the works of contemporary designers like Charles Rennie Mackintosh and his peers. The simplistic style of Shaker furniture and the wealth of Shaker furniture history make the style popular even in modern context. Although the furniture is now less common, and indeed with only 4 remaining Shakers certainly dying out, it is a style that is very much in demand for its minimalistic styling and simple quality. This has given rise to an increasing number of manufacturer-based furniture around the Shaker designs, which are now mass-produced and readily available. Like the Shaker way of life, the Shaker furniture history has been shaped by simplistic, minimalist living and by hard work and dedication. Additionally, it is heralded as designed significantly ahead of its time and has given rise to numerous copycat designers and manufacturers the world over. As far as Shaker original furniture goes, you aren't likely to come across any unless you visit a museum, but the mass-produced furniture which takes an inspiration from Shaker furniture history is founded on the same principles of design and can allow an affordable alternative for modern design. Shaker furniture has a long and detailed history, and it is sure to live on in the memories of those who appreciate their furniture as essentially a work of art.
We will all go home with you, home to worlds of glory, where an eternal interview awaits the pure and holy. We will all go home with you, home to worlds of glory, where an eternal interview awaits the pure and holy. Bless the soul's connecting bond, which the cross ensureth. We meet in time, but our love endureth. Bless the soul's connecting bond, which the cross ensureth. We may never meet in time, but our love endureth.